go through and touch up some stuff. I'm going to use the Orbe today. We'll leave those out for now. Start here. And I'm going to hold the hank of hair firmly, and I'm not going to reposition my hand. That way I get a modern curl instead of a boop-de-boop curl. So we watched Bad Blood, the whole season of it, probably in two nights. It's kind of a Soprano-ish type thing. I don't know if it was a season or that's all it was, a series. So and it was good. It was good. Well, obviously, if we blew through it in two nights, I think there were probably 5 or 6 episodes. I could have gotten by with not styling my hair at all today because it didn't look that bad. But I thought I would just give you another look at this technique that I'm trying now. Hold it firmly. Oh, I changed direction on that one. I changed my grip on that piece of hair. Let me back off. Y'all can see my messy desk now. That's all right. Sometimes you have to be messy when you're creative, right? It ruins the flow if you stop and try to neaten as you go. See, I'm not wrapping it flat. I think it's key to let the curls cool before you draw them. All right, let's do the front. I'm going to take just the very front pieces, this much, and roll that under. And then take another middle piece and roll that under. And then I'm going to take this piece and roll it back. Where I judged where I'm going to roll it forward, where I'm going to roll it backward, like if I had on a headband. In front of the headband, I'm going to roll it forward, and behind the headband, I'm going to roll it back. Still taking some of these bangs. A word of warning, if you were thinking of getting the Bardot bangs, consider the fact that it makes the front look thinner. That's why I have to tease so much up here. I'll give this a little spray. Sometimes these really healthy pieces underneath don't drop, don't hold curl as well. Alright. So Pat heated up my car before he left, so y'all won't be cold when we get in the car. All right, I'm gonna go take a look at the back of my hair and make sure I didn't miss any vital pieces. Be right back. Okay, it looks good. It looks like I got everything. So I'm going to beach wave spray. Going to tease in here, tease this forward. Tease this back. How's that? I'm gonna go check the back and make sure that I don't have any holes, and I'll be right back.
Separated. Hey! Man, you're disrespecting me. Take them out. You gotta keep them separated. Hey, hey, don't pay no mind.
Now I want something somewhat greasy to go in the front. Okay, this is called Down and Out Dirty Spray. I do like my veins to look a little dirty. That's a teenager going to school. All right, there you go. I'm gonna unplug the curling iron. Curling iron unplugged! If y'all forget things, that's the best way to remember them, is to yell them after you do them, and then you remember you did it, right? Okay, here's a piece that needs to be. That's pretty, isn't it? Let's do another one. Those are so pretty. Okay. And I'm holding the piece of hair firmly in my hand and not switching hand position. That way it twists each time I go around. You'll also find that if you're trying to put the fishing line back on your fishing rod, if you do it by hand, it twists the line and makes a big snarl. But if you crank it in with the handle of the fishing reel, it rolls it on without putting a twist in it. Same general idea. I know. Who would have ever thought that fishing line and hair have anything in common? There we go. All right, I'm gonna go get dressed and I'll meet you in the kitchen to show you an outfit of the day. Thanks for keeping me company while I put my face on, and catch you in.
Well, let's go, but I'm Gerald. Yeah. And I can always have just what I want. She's the baddest, I would love to flaunt. Take her shopping, you know Eve Saint Laurent.